It was back in 2003 when Pyeongchang made its first bid to host the Winter Olympics, and on its third try, the provincial town in Gangwon was chosen as the site for the 2018 Winter Olympics. The city's nearly two-decade attempt became a reality. After all that time, the Winter Games came to an end on February 22nd's closing ceremony. Since the 1990s, Korea has been in the top 10 nations in medal count in almost every Winter Olympics, but most of the medals came from short track speed skating. But in Pyeongchang, Team Korea's source of medals has been diversified. We had our first gold and silver in skeleton and skiing, and more Korean speed skaters won medals than ever before. Of all the events, the women's curling team, aka Garlic Girls, became a national sensation when they snatched silver in their first appearance in the Olympics. The shouting and sweeping of the Korean curlers have become a national phenomenon and created curling mania for the first time in Korean sports history. In the 17 days of excitement, Korea has shown its potential to become a winter sports powerhouse. When big sporting events such as the Olympics or World Cup are over, we hear about the downside of the events, especially the financial issues. It's difficult to recoup all the money spent to build stadiums and facilities, so the host cities tend to pile up huge debt. Pyeongchang seems to be no exception, but Koreans hope that this issue will too be addressed, as hosting the Winter Olympics and having world-class winter sports athletes weren't even in the minds of most Koreans a decade ago. Thousands of dedicated and friendly Korean volunteers were a key factor in creating a successful Winter Olympics. Yeah, so I mentioned key factor. When we see key factor, it means kind of like a main reason or the main point of an effort or how something is done. So we said that since they were dedicated and friendly, that was one of the key factors or main reasons the Olympics went so smoothly and were so successful. One main factor that made an outstanding Winter Games was the huge number of unpaid volunteers. Koreans have changed their attitude about winning medals. The consensus is not how many medals Korea wins, but if the nation's athletes tried their hardest. So I said the consensus is not how many medals are won. The consensus is kind of a general thought or general feeling of a large group of people. It's kind of the majority way of thinking. So if you have 10 people and 8 people agree, that's the consensus. So we say consensus. Korean perception of the Winter Games has shifted from the amount of medals earned to national pride in breaking into new areas of sport. So we talk about that Koreans have kind of changed their way of thinking from medals earned to national pride, breaking into new areas of sport. So in the previous Olympics, Koreans were meddling in speed skating, but now they've broken into. So when you break into somewhere, you're doing something new or accomplishing something new. So they broke into new areas of sport, such as skeleton, bobsleigh, and skiing. The Korean women's curling team drew a lot of attention. The captain's commands have become a household phrase across the country. So we use a household phrase or a household name. That means that a name, a place, or a thing is known in every house in an area or a country. For example, you say something like Coca-Cola. That's a household name around the world. Everybody knows Coca-Cola. But if you were to name an actor, let's say, I don't know, Yuji Tae, he is a household name in Korea. Everybody knows his name, but not necessarily a household name in other countries like the United States. So the phrases that the captain was shouting have become a household phrase in Korea, meaning most everyone knows about this phrase. The women's curling captain's commands like keep moving and shouting her team players' names have been a national sensation. Viewers have made internet memes that have become popular through social media. So we talked about the all of the things that the captain said and all she did. A lot of people parodied that and put her face on internet memes. So internet memes are things that people create of popular things that might have happened or popular pictures that might have happened. And some people put captions under these pictures, and they get sent around through social media or SNS. And then once they become popular, they become what we call memes. To go further, yeah, memes are GIFs or pictures or short videos or anything, or even animations that can become popular on the internet. Korea has excelled in new and different winter sports, including skeleton, skiing, and bobsleigh. So I said excelled. So if you excel in something, you do very well in something, or you learn something very quickly and do better. So previously, Korea was not that good in skeleton, skiing, and bobsleighing, but this year they earned medals in that category. So we say they excelled. Korea's medal count was more varied in the Winter Olympics. Koreans podiumed in new sports, including skeleton, skiing, and bobsleigh. So I use the word Koreans podiumed. So if you think of a podium, it's where you give a speech, but it, as a noun. But we can sometimes use podium as a verb, meaning when they stand on those stands and get the gold, the silver, and the bronze, that's the Olympic podium. So we've turned it into a verb. So if you say, did Korea podium in bobsleighing? Yes, they did. They won a silver. So to use the word podium means to earn a medal. And it doesn't have to be the Olympics. It can be any type of sport where there's a first, second, or third, and a medal given. We also use the verb to medal. So Korea medaled in skeleton. They medaled. They won a gold medal. Or did they medal? Yes, they did medal. They won the gold. So we've used podium and medal as verbs now. To maximize the investment we made in the Winter Games, we need to focus on the best way to use the new facilities and create a better appreciation of winter sports. So I said we need to maximize the investment. So Korea invested a lot of money. And in order to use that money and use the facilities, we kind of have to use our efforts and maximize our interest and our efforts into using these things. If we don't use them to the full potential, we are not maximizing it. And then I said, to create a better appreciation of winter sports. So, you know, in the past, winter sports or alpine sports, they've not been that popular in Korea. But now that Korea has done, you know, a lot and medaled a lot in these winter sports, there's a general appreciation for these winter sports. So if people start getting interested in them, they can appreciate them more and start practicing and playing these winter sports, thus being able to use the facilities and make sure they don't go to waste. A greater focus on alpine sports should be encouraged so that future generations can maintain the current passion created by the recent Olympics. This will guarantee future use of the winter sports structures. So I said that focus on alpine sports should be encouraged. So future generations, when I say future generations, that means our children and our children's children, they can maintain the current passion created by the recent Olympics. So the recent Olympics, it created a lot of passion and energy and a lot of interest. So we need to maintain that passion, and that will help be able to maintain these Olympic facilities, make them profitable, and encourage young people to participate in winter sports. Thanks very much, guys, and congratulations to Team Korea.